Well, as is the case with the majority of snowfalls in the state, Carroll County saw some of the highest snow totals.
11 News reporter Kai Reed joins us live from Westminster tonight with a look at the conditions there. Kai.
Well, Stan and Donna, the snow has stopped falling, thankfully, and the conditions have improved considerably. Emergency officials say that road crews have made a lot of progress, but they still have a lot of work to do before the morning commute. We ran into Pam Miller after a long day of work, dreading what she knows will be a long and treacherous drive home.
The driving, I guess, is the hardest part. I wanted to call out. I really did, but it's like, oh, well, I'll give it a shot. As long as I can, you know, get there.
Are you worried about the drive home?
Yes, I'm more worried about the drive home.
Carroll County had 90 trucks on the road at the height of the storm, plowing and salting 63 routes throughout the county.
The roads are not good at all. They're very hard to drive with, especially if you don't have four-wheel drive.
This private plow truck driver told us that he was on his 10th parking lot of the day, and he expected to be at it all night. For emergency officials, the biggest concern as the wind started to pick up was blowing and drifting snow.
They'll be working throughout the night to continue to plow. With the winds, there's going to be drifts. So they'll continue to hit the roadways pretty hard and continue to treat them so that in the morning time for the morning rush, hopefully the main roadways and the secondary roadways are clear.
A lot of businesses in Westminster shut down by mid-afternoon to ensure that employees and customers would get home safely, a tactic that state and county officials say helped out considerably.
People are kind of heeding that advice. We haven't had too many serious accidents, a lot of people sliding off the roadways into ditches, culverts, that kind of thing.
And now county officials are warning drivers about some very slick spots on the roadways and also drifting snow that they think will continue throughout the night. They hope to have the primary and secondary roads done by 7 or 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. And they also say that that drifting snow issue will probably continue well into tomorrow. Reporting live in Carroll County, Kai Reed, WBAL TV 11 News.
All right, Kai, thank you. To Baltimore City now, where health officials are very concerned about the growing number of homeless people who may be out in the cold tonight.
11 News reporter George Lettuce continues our team coverage tonight from North Baltimore with efforts to keep people safe. And George, I know this is really serious business for the city.
Well, right. The mayor and a wide range of city officials held a news conference, and they really talked a lot about this topic tonight. People keeping the vulnerable populations in Baltimore City safe and sound. Sherry White calls Baltimore City's Fallsway homeless shelter home, and she's especially glad she's got a bed to sleep in tonight. But some choose to stay on the streets. Because you couldn't bear this cold tonight.
No, no, not at all.
What about the people that do?
I feel sorry for them. I keep them in my prayer.
With the snow and frigid temperatures, Baltimore leadership is worried about hypothermia deaths. So the city's under a code blue, which means in part it's trying to round up as many homeless people as possible and encourage them to come inside.
Precipitation can accelerate the risk for hypothermia. And so with these extreme temperatures that we anticipate later on this evening, it can take anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes for the early signs of frostbite to start taking into effect.
Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake says the city has a rough count of the homeless and knows where they usually stay, and the city promises to have enough beds.
We will make arrangements for everyone that is on the street and needs to get off the street.
Meanwhile, 200 salt and plow truck drivers are working overtime to clear as many city streets as possible, but the city knows it will get complaints from people living on secondary and side roads. Many of them tonight have a thick blanket of snow.
We encourage people to call in and report icy conditions. We have a process where we take in that information. We put it on list. We have inspectors throughout the city that are going to investigate.
And to make such reports about your roads, call 311. That's the city's hotline, and that is operating 24 hours. We're live in North Baltimore. George Lettuce, WBAL TV 11 News.
All right, thanks, George. And how many times do you hear people say, yes, call us with your complaints about the roads?
Oh, yeah.
Most unusual.
Exactly.
Well, Howard County also saw significant snowfall.
Yeah,
today.
11 News reporter Kate Amara has been monitoring the conditions there all day. She joins us live from Ellicott City with the very latest. Hi, Kate.
Hi, you know, the concern right now for Howard County officials is the cold, and I can tell you that within the last half an hour, you can really feel how far the temperatures have plunged. We've been standing out here for the better part of 10 hours, and this is the first time that my face feels like it's freezing, that I can really feel just how cold it is. Because of that, Howard County schools are closed again tomorrow. Howard County employees have liberal leave for tomorrow. And even though the snow has tapered off, this is not over yet. It has been a very long day for Wayne Phillips.
Yes, and it's going to be a whole lot longer before it's over with. We'll be here at least till the morning.
He's contracted to keep this parking lot clear through a storm that just didn't want to cooperate. By 7 p.m., at least 6 inches had fallen, and it was a dry, light, fluffy snow that was blowing and drifting in stiff winds.
It's blowing over where we've just plowed, so along with this light snow, now we have the wind picking up, and it's going to pick up worse all night, I think.
Much the same story on the roads. Officials said the main road stayed in pretty good shape thanks to light volume. 1,100 miles for Howard County to clear.
So far, people seem to be staying off the roads. The calls for accidents and incidents are within reasonable level.
That's County Executive Ken Allman. As the snow tapered off and the temperatures plunged, his biggest worry became the wind chill.
It's going to be very cold tonight. We don't know what the icing conditions are going to be overnight. So everybody just play it as cautiously as possible and be safe.
Please stay home. Stay home tomorrow morning. It's nothing on this earth is worth coming out in this.
Just stay home and let those guys get their job done. In case you're wondering about your neighborhood, Howard County officials tell us it'll probably be midday tomorrow before all the neighborhood roads are clear. Reporting live from Ellicott City, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Kate, thank you.